So we'll start the maneuvers. Inno hindi pa? Yeah. So no, that precautions, all that steps I'm just going to skip. Just show the maneuvers, okay? So first, dixalpike. Turn the head 45 degrees to this side. That is it. Take him down in one rapid step. Okay. And 20 degrees down. Okay. Max 30, not more than that. Okay. This is dixalpike. At that time, look into the eyes. Ask the patient to look at you. Okay. And then get up. That is it. This is testing the right side. If you want to test the left side, turn to left side and do it. Okay. Eply, first step is the same as dixalpike. Then by 90 degrees means compared to this 90 degrees. So it will be opposite. So this side 45 degrees to this side 45 degrees. Okay. Then roll him over. This is the time when somebody, patient's relative, somebody comes and tells them what is the end of the couch. Ask them to roll over and look downwards. Okay. Then after this, okay, ask him to lift fold the legs up, fold the legs up. As if he's going to get down now, put one leg down, as if you're going to get down. Yeah, and then up. At this time, make sure that you don't hyperextend, okay, or not even straight. I prefer to keep it a little bent, because when I do that, the vertical limb will be most vertical, okay. Otherwise, it will tend to be like this. So if it is most vertical, the chances of. Then regularly what I do, a small modification is, after this, I make the patient to jump down. Jump. Okay. The reason is, when it is in the vertical limb, that rapid deceleration will make the last bit just slip off. Slip off. Okay. That is one thing that I've been regularly doing. Okay. So that is dixalpic over, eply over. What else? In Nepal. Okay. See, in the beginning, I used to do the history-wise, which canal is affected, that effect. Then I've changed that now after reading that. There's a book, Susan Hertzman, where it says that you do on the side that is not involved first, and then, okay, so that if there is a problem there, you can detect it. Okay. And so now it is changed to that. I do the uninvolved size clean history. Yeah. Yeah. Other dixalpic also. No, as of now. Now I have to start putting some thought to that, whether we should screen everything after Dr. Sharma has told in the afternoon about testing all the things. So I will really give some serious thought into that and probably incorporate that also into practice. Okay. I was telling about you to test all the, and you are not, to about testing all the canals. Yes, sir. Okay, sir. Yeah, Simons, I will show you. Yeah. Simons has to be done very, very rapidly. I'll stand behind so that you can actually see what is happening. Parietal eminence, frontal eminence. Okay. And whichever side is involved, to the opposite side, the person should see. But to the involved side, the person should fall. Okay. So make him fall to this side. This has to be very fast, okay? I'm standing behind, so I cannot do that fast. So this way. This occipital eminence should come and with a rapid deceleration, come and touch here. You're leaving, sir? Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you. Doctor? Okay. Yeah. Dr. Sandeep Sharma is leaving. Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Okay. So this way. Then, again, very fast, you have to take him to the opposite side. Now I'm showing it slowly, but touch this frontal eminence should now touch. Wait. Sir, I am little conservative in the sense I wait prolonged. I wait for 1.5 minutes or even more. But there are people who just wait till the nystagmus resolves. Okay. So once again, so if this is the affected ear, this occipital eminence should this parietal eminence should touch the table first. Then the opposite. So you are not. What happens is generally first time people are doing, they will turn it off. That is wrong. So they should just maintain that head position, keep it leftwards only untouched. Okay. Generally, what happens? The most important mistake that when CMONT is being done unsupervised is this. They do it this, but then by the time it comes, this will be touching. That is wrong. Okay. Fine. Generally, whoever comes from Europe, everybody tells they do only CMONTs, irrespective of the weight. Whoever comes from US, they only do EPLI. So I don't know what we are. But we are very happy. No ideas. There are other factors when it comes to what maneuver you do. If you are supposed to do a maneuver in the ward, okay, where the couch does not have the open end where your head can hang, then CMONT becomes handy. Whereas if your clinic, you have the couch the way you want it for the head to hang, then you can do EPLI maneuver. It's like that. Guffoni? Shall we do Guffoni and Iacovino and everything? Iacovino I'll show. This is for anterior canal, Iacovino, Bahinde. Yeah. Testing is, see, basically, testing of anterior canal also is like dixalpic. Instead of getting the nystagmus direction will be opposite, that's all. Okay. So you do this, hyperextend. Okay, this is one test where a little, you have to be very careful that person's neck is fine. Don't think the thin-necked people don't have a cervical thing problem. Okay, even thin people can have problems. Okay, so we have to first ask him for the static, how much they can move. Hyperextend, then disextend, lift, wait, then sit up. Okay, in each position, wait. Okay, wait for some time. That is it. Fine, that was Iacovino. Last, Guffoni. Okay. Diagnostic test, McClure Pegnini, only the name is McClure Pegnini. That also I will show. Then after that, we'll go for Guffoni. Okay. So this is nothing much. Supine, turn to one side, horizontal canal. Come back, turn to the other side, and come back. Not required, sir. For horizontal canal, nothing is required. It will just come up. Okay. Then comes Guffoni. Okay. The Guffoni idea is that if this horizontal semicircular canal has debris sitting here, you rapidly make it, okay, you make the head go and hit so that when the head rapidly decelerates, this accelerates and goes and falls into the vestibule. Okay. And then it may not fall immediately, it may just be at the opening where the semicircular canal is opening into the vestibule. At that time, you make one more movement in the opposite direction and then it slips off. That is the idea. So how you do that? Just hold it like this. You have to very rapidly go and make it hit. What I've done now is not at all enough. This has to be done very rapidly. The pillow should be soft. Okay. So go fast, suddenly stop. Then, once the nystagmus settles, immediately the person will get nystagmus. After the nystagmus has settled, wait for some time. After that, do this. That also has to be very fast. Okay. So this depends on decelation. So this is for this year. So think that this year. If this is the year affected, fall rapidly, and then turn. Okay. This is a little violent kind of maneuver. This is for left ear. This is for left ear. Because left ear is like this. It has to fall into the vestibule. You have to make something. It is like you are taking some some container, from container you are trying to make something drop out. You are hitting, tuck, tuck, like that. So for the left side, you have to hit towards the right side so that it falls out, falls in. Okay, like that. Then, of course, more easier than that would be barbecue roll. So barbecue roll, again, if whichever side is involved, akade malko, malko. Okay, kelako. Turn the patient to the opposite side. So if the person is, if right side is involved, okay, right side is the involved canal, then turn the person towards the opposite side. Okay, roll. One roll, ulta full roll, next. Okay, so full, ottemel malkobeku. Okay. One more roll, okay. Then again, one more half roll, ikadege, akadege akal, ulta, ulta, same, same. That's it. Only this much. Okay. 360 degree is not recommended. 270 degrees, get up. This is for horizontal canal. Okay. So you should get up to that side.